Are you driving an API program initiative within your organization and facing challenges both from the consumption and production side? Challenges like, are your API consumers easily searching for APIs related to run an end-to-end business use case? Are your API owners or administrators struggling to provide access individually to each and every API for different consumers based on different SLAs? Hello, my name is Ishupal Singh. I'm a customer success architect at MuleSoft. And today I'm going to talk about how at MuleSoft we are continuously improving our platform to streamline that production consumption model of the APIs. And specifically, we are going to talk about API groups within the Anypoint platform. Consider a case where a bank is deploying a set of APIs to realize a customer 360 program, which will require apps team to consume APIs managed by a different line of businesses. Let us see how API groups can handle or enable customers to effectively consume the set of APIs for a specific business need, and API group administrators can easily manage the group, version, and SLAs. Let's move to the platform and see how API groups can help streamline that production and consumption model. To demonstrate, I have defined set of APIs spread across the different line of businesses. And this is a fictional use case. There are set of assets which are available in Bank Core. And let's quickly navigate to them. If you see, there are two different APIs, Banking Account System API, which has one version, and Banking System API, which has two different versions. These two APIs, along with the API from the master domain, are required to fulfill an end-to-end business use case. What are the different ways in which we can provide those APIs to the consumers so that they are able to consume those APIs in an efficient way? One of the ways is that we individually share access or provide access to each of those consumers per API. However, that becomes a tedious process if the consumer base increases and also if the number of APIs and the versions increase. Let's start to look into how API groups can help overcome these challenges. Once we have the API group administrator privileges, we can go ahead and create an API group. This API group would be bundled as a logical unit, which will house multiple APIs which are required to perform an end-to-end business use case. This would enable us to move from feature-oriented model to more of a product-oriented model. So we are now positioning API as products. So let's say banking customer 360. Provide a link, demo API group. If you notice, the API group name, versioning, and label, they are in line with what we used to see when we create the APIs. Let's hit continue. Once we create the logical unit, the API group, we are presented with a canvas where we can start adding individual APIs from different environments. So let's say that from my bank master and sandbox environment, I need the banking experience API to realize the banking customer 360. However, we also require APIs from the different business group, which is my bank core, which is handling my system APIs. I select the environment. One thing to note over here is that API groups, though they use it span across business groups, but we can only club the APIs from the same environment. Meaning, if I'm on banking master, if I'm working on a sandbox environment, I can only club the APIs from different business groups which are residing in the sandbox environment. Once we have selected the API, let's say I need the banking account system API, I can select the version. Or let's say if we have the ability to set or add different versions to the APIs as well. So For now, let's do one. Once I click save, what has happened is we have bundled the offerings into one API product, which would be easier for an owner to manage because now once consumers start making requests to these APIs, he only has to control the access for one particular group. For example, once we publish this to Exchange and we navigate to Exchange, what we'll see is we have a banking customer 360 as an asset API group come up. And if you see, it is now showing that this has two different API instances. Now, coming from the consumer side, instead of requesting access for multiple APIs, now I can go and request access for a group. Let's say demo API group. I create a new application. Let's say demo app group. And when we do that, we are presented with the application, which would house the two different APIs. So what we have achieved from using the API groups is one, sharing access from a production side has become easier. From a consumption side, I as a consumer now get the complete offering rather than going and searching for what all use cases would require, what all different APIs. All those policies and SLAs that we are adding on APIs, they still remain. However, now with API group in place, we get to add SLA tiers on group level as well. For example, if we have multiple consumers looking for this particular as a product, based upon the consumer tier, I can create the different SLAs that would come into play and while we are invoking the APIs underneath APIs. I hope this helps to understand more about how API groups can help leverage the production consumption model. Thank you for watching the video. I hope this helped to understand how API groups can be used to drive that production consumption model. For further reading, I recommend logging into MuleSoft documentation site and following the documentation. Thanks.